dear viewers, this is NefFTW, and welcome back to another video in the Nearly Out series. This one is Madden 2004, and basically what I wanted to do was basically just say, you know what, I want to be able to just to play a game without actually having to play the game. And so that's what I'm going to do. I'm just going to let this game play out like it does. Now, I've made this. This is coming, I mean, obviously, this is coming out after the Super Bowl. So, I decided, you know what? I have this game. Why don't I just make it fun and put the Patriots versus the Falcons in the exact same condition, as close as I can make it, the exact same conditions that they were in before. I did my best, I looked it up, all that kind of stuff, you know, whatever. I have no idea how long this is going to take. If it takes too long, like, way too long, I am just going to just say, yeah, fuck it. It'll cut to the end just to see, just to show off who would have won in 2003. Yeah, 2003. This is important data I'm doing right here. Very important. But yeah, I just decided, you know what, I might as well do this. We don't really have to focus on the game in any respect. Oh. Did I set it on 5 or something? No, it's impossible. Wow. Look at those amazing people in the audience. But yeah, anyway. Yeah, I just want to talk about things. So I can maybe, you know, ramble like a jackass, like usual, eh? But yeah. What's one of the things I want to talk about? Right. One thing I want to talk about is something that I've always had concerns with. Something like that. It's just, whenever you play, well, not just play a game, but you're in a world, like you're looking in some sort of fantasy world, reading stories about it, playing a game, watching a movie, something like that, right? And there are people, you know, people, rather common, no, just common people going about, you know, peasants and millers and farmers and shopkeepers, you know, things like that. Just normal, everyday people, right? And those people constantly make, like, comments of, like, oh, I don't know, what's all this weird stuff happening? Or, like, perfect example, in Skyrim, alright? In Skyrim, there is a story. It was a whole shit ton of stories, but there's a story that two burglars entering a house, and they go to, you know, steal everything in this house. The family had been killed and all that kind of stuff. And what? There's the ghosts of the family there, of the family that had been killed by something. Alright? Now, one of the comments, one of the thieves is obviously quite freaked out about all this kind of stuff. While the other thief is going around saying, what, they can't see you, what are you, superstitious? It's like, I don't see, are you superstitious of the ghosts that are right in front of us? And that their magic is a thing that exists. There are mages. It is a thing that exists to the point where people don't like people who use magic, and yet they do not put it in their head that magic is a thing. I mean, it's a really easy trope to do. just saying, oh, magic doesn't exist. But when you have people just wandering around, when you have elves and humans and Nords and all, and everything like that, that use magic and can bring magic anywhere, and you can show it off, and people say, oh, what? What is that? No? Magic. What is that? What are you talking about? It really annoys me. And it's like, do you know where you live? Do you know the place around you? I literally have a spell which can turn iron into silver and silver into gold. It's absurd. It really is, and I'm really kind of tired of it. I mean, shit. I don't know. It's a really annoying thing. How are things going? Oh. Who's Atlanta? Yeah. Atlanta's doing, well, no one's got any points yet. We're still in the first quarter, and it's been about 5.5, 6 minutes. It's 6 minutes according to my, recording. Well, 6:15. Recording time. Ah, God. And my recording time is what I'm basically... is... I do have a weird system about going about things. Oh! This is coming out... I believe this is going to be number 6? Something like that. Probably is. But, I actually fixed my problem that I was having with my GameCube. The problem wasn't with the GameCube itself, but it was with the computer. I hadn't actually, the problem was I hadn't restarted my computer recently, and so I basically had to do that in order to make it not screw up. Really easy. But yeah. So how's your day going? You don't even see me. I'm not even looking at the TV anymore. I'm just reclining, looking at the ceiling. It's like, oh, man. This is really boring now, isn't it? Actually, no, it's not boring. It's what I do a good amount of the time. Just sit and ramble to myself. I can do a good job at it. It's just, you know, when I'm playing a game, I always kind of focus myself at it. Oh well. Nearly 8 minutes now. What's going on? Oh! I don't actually really buy sports games. I actually never have. I've never bought a sports game. The reason why I have Madden 2004 is the same reason why I have the GT Pro Series for the Wii. It's because one of my relatives knew that I liked video games, so they bought some for me. And I will be honest, although I don't play sports games really, I did actually have a bit of fun with the Madden 2004. God, when did I get these? I think I got them 2009. 2009? Really? The quarterback gets set with only shit, it was, wasn't it? It was before I got my phone that many people have called. Many people have called. A drug dealer phone. Which is... I mean, I guess it's true. I mean, it's just... a drug dealer phone is anything that's not a smartphone, basically. It could be a brick phone, too. Yeah. Man, look at that drug dealer phone. Just... The Falcons expecting pass as they line up with 7 defensive backs. And it's caught. Watch it here. This is a great call on... I've heard inside that brick phone is in fact cocaine. So that's how he carries the drugs. The drugs. Oh god, this game looks horrible. I shouldn't be complaining because I play Skyrim quite a bit. oh man, this game looks horrible. So let me just go back to Skyrim where everyone's faces look detailed in some ways. I recently got a special edition. I think I said this in Shrek 2 1. The 8th one. I made a mention that I'd gotten Skyrim Special Edition. And it's great. It's Skyrim. I have it on the 360, mostly because I tried to sell it, but I forgot that I actually still had the actual game disc still in the 360. I still haven't taken it out. I should do that, actually. But yeah, I played it a lot. I didn't have mods before, but now I do. Favorite one is the Time Stop mod. It's fantastic. It's alright, before I continue along my original tangent, I'm going off on a little tangent. Right, I recently got a mod called, like, Fendrix's World DLC, where it's basically just Fendrix's magic and all the other mods he does. But I basically, there's super tough enemies in that, and it's kind of expected that you try to dodge the hits, but, you know, be able to take it and all that kind of stuff. What you do is you get the Time Stop mod, and you can just go around punching them, shooting magic at them, they can hardly do a thing. But anyway, that's a little tangent I went off on, but let's get back on track a little. I did get Skyrim Special Edition for the PS4, and it is fun. It's great. I really like it, and I like the mods. Well, the mods I have, the mods that are currently available, some of them at least. But there's some things about the games you can't fix. Like, one, the faces look better, but they're still incredibly detailed. And by incredibly detailed, I mean ugly as sin. They're not great. Oh, man. Gotta wipe my eyes. A bunch of shit in it. Ow. But yeah. Actually, I'm not a big fan of the, of what Sony's basically done with the, mods that are going up for it, because one of the absolute worst things, I mean, is not allowing them to do, to import their own files or scripts for the mods, and having them work solely with the assets in Skyrim. And that is terrible. Because there's a whole bunch of amazing shit. And you always got I mean, of course I have some issues with Sony as a company. But it's just a thing I'm not a fan of. I mean, honestly, they're hurt. The only thing they're doing is hurting themselves. No, that was a tackle. I want to see a football fight where it's just stand battles. Stand football. That'd be great. Oh, we're in the second quarter now. Two, maybe 3 yards on the ground for the fullback. Man. I remember one time I made a team with this. I can never save it because I forget. I think this game requires like a stupid amount of save slot things. A couple, maybe 3 yards on that run. And ow. We only ever had one memory card for the GameCube. So, and we had a whole bunch of games. I still have most of them. I actually got rid of quite a few. And another number of them broke. Hold on, I'm just trying to think about it. Oh my god, is that the second time? Okay, I used to own the Shadow the Hedgehog game, right? And you can say whatever you want about it. I was young at the time, and when I was young, I kind of enjoyed playing it, never really finished it. But I had fun, though, and that was the important part. But, god, it was sometime later. When he actually had some more cash, and I was like, you know what? When I lost the game some time ago. Or I lost the first time I got that game. So when I had some money, I was like, you know what? I'm going to go out. I'm going to get the game again. I'm going to play it. Just remember nostalgia, you know? And I played it, and I beat it, and I had still had some fun. And then I lost it again. I mean, seriously, I don't know where it is. And I didn't do anything with it. And that's, like... I think it's like the only game I've ever had that's ever just gone missing. What is it? Oh, Patriots don't like the right. I thought the Patriots were all about the right. Whatever. But, anything else interesting to talk about? Oh, I'm certain I have something I can talk about. Ow. You know, I do occasionally have talks. I have chats with people on a Discord channel. And one of those chats is even called the... I swear to God, called the Cancer Cast. With someone calls himself Lord Cancer. And, they're a great guy. They're great. But, that's... Yeah. I kind of want to try to get them on here. Maybe catch a bit of Cancer Cast. The Falcons come out in a nickel pack. Yeah, I've always tried to work on my accents. You know, just toss him to the ground, fucker. Just suplex him. Tiger driver. Backbreaker. From the ropes. Oh my god, someone climbs on top of one of the field goal posts, and just a flying tackle into one of the players. Oh, there's a guy in the ring. You know, there are times when you have to remember, where I have to remember, that I am sitting in a room, by myself, making jokes and laughing at them. It's kind of a sobering thing, and whenever you're trying to do commentary, especially by yourself, it's not something you want to think about. Don't let it set in. Don't let it set in. Oh God, it set in. Oh hey, look, New England has gotten. Oh, shit. Wait, what? Okay. Whoops. That was my choice, I guess. Or, that might have been my choice. I don't know. We'll get an update from Melissa as soon as the extent of the injury is known. It's just... I just love that. I can't believe I almost missed that. It's just like, well, I'm gonna run this way. Nope. Just shoves him back. You can make some really big players, I think. Let me see. How long is this going to be? Well, I did kind of dick around a little bit at the beginning. This is probably going to be about 40 minutes. About 40 minutes. That's... I can stand that. Let's see if I can talk for 40 minutes and not run out of things. Ooh, I'm going to run out of things. I know I will. But we're having fun, and that's what matters. You know, I always liked Frasier. It was always a really good show. And, I mean, Frasier is what every spinoff should aspire to be. Right? Maybe they shouldn't be exactly the same. I mean, they shouldn't try to do the exact same thing that Frasier did. You know, with the... shit. I'm trying to do something else. They shouldn't try to do the same exact same thing that Frasier did, you know, the exact same plot lines and all that kind of stuff. But what it was, that's what they should aspire to be. Because when you say Frasier, when you think, when someone says it, your first thought isn't, oh, that cheer spinoff. No, you think, oh, Frasier. The TV show with Frasier Crane. And his brother and all their antics and all that kind of stuff. And if I say Cheers, you don't think, oh, that precursor to Frasier. No, you think Cheers with Jack and Elaine? I haven't watched Cheers that much. But, I mean, Frasier is what every spinoff should try to be. In that you don't think of it as a spinoff. You think of it as its own separate show. And that's what a lot of them don't get. Because a lot of spinoffs try to just say, hey, this is popular, why don't we capitalize on it? And I mean, I'm not going to say that Frasier wasn't, but they tried to do something new. Tried to go off in a different way. They didn't try to reuse every little tiny bit of Cheers. They didn't try to shove multiple Cheers members into it. They gave Frasier already had his own personnel. And he wasn't a comic relief. That's a very important thing. What a lot of spinoffs do, is they try to make a show off the comic relief because they get the laughs and people like them. You can't do that. You shouldn't do that. Trying to build a TV show off the comic relief is like trying to make a parody based off of fart jokes. Second field goal attempt before halftime. It sounds like a good idea because you'll get people to laugh, but it's not a good idea because it won't be remembered. If it'll be remembered, it's the wrong way. Because there's two types of comedy. I personally believe there are two types of comedy. Right? There's comedy that gets the comedy that tries to get a laugh, and comedy that tries to be funny. The comedy that tries to get a laugh is, you know, it's maybe physical humor and all that kind of stuff. It's more, what's the term I want to use? Lowbrow? This pass is incomplete. Harrison was in perfect position and knocked that pass away. But comedy that tries to be funny, that tries to, maybe not try, maybe it doesn't try to get you to burst out laughing, great reaction shot, all that kind of stuff. But it's something that you remember, that you enjoy, you think about, and it's like, I really like that. And that's what a lot of the things I like. I mean, I rewatch a lot of the same movies because I really like those movies and they're really funny to me. I'm talking out my ass half the time though. Oh God, guys, you've been in like the last 2 minutes for the past 5. I can understand. understand why these usually go into long into the night. Oh my god, don't stop calling timeouts. I know why you are. It's so you can get a field. Yeah, there it is. Field goal. That's what they're trying for.
Feely will attempt to put up the first points of the day.
I hope you whiff it.
And it's on its way. It's good.
Yeah, of course you don't whiff it. In this game, it is, I mean, after you like get a touchdown and all that kind of stuff, is that a field goal is so stupidly easy that you would have to be absolutely horrible at this game to not get a field goal.
And the kickoff team comes out onto the field.
And of course, actually, this game is really easy to get your team to win. Because all you have to do, the only thing you have to do is play it, is switch to the other team and just play it horribly. Just play them shittily. Have them just run off in random directions.
Ball on their own 23.
Why is it taking so long for you to just end this one? Just finish it. Finish them. Thank God. I might actually have to cut this down. You know what? I want to switch. But I don't have the money for it. I really don't have the money for it. Yeah. Look at those hat girls. Those amazingly hot 2004. I don't know. Every time I say a date for a game, I'm always wrong. I am always wrong. I can't help but be wrong. You know, I might have been able to actually shorten the time of these games. But why should I? Because this game, should, in theory, only take 20 minutes. Only take 20 minutes. The problem is, because playing this game gives me bigger clues as to how this work. Games like the, not games like this, but how football works, right? Oh god. That was bad. But anyway, I might as well just do this since I'm not doing anything else. The way it works is that if you have the ball and if you're running, right? If you run it and you get tackled, the clock still runs. If you try to throw for a pass and the pass is not received by anyone, time does not continue. I think that was like the only two big ones. And every time you use a timeout, time again stops. Run, bit. Oh, shit. Wait, have there been other turnovers? What? Like I said, I've not been paying attention. And I'm not going to either. I really want to play Breath of the Wild. The new Legend of Zelda game. It's coming out. The same times. It's Nier Automata. 5-yard pickup on that run by the tailback. Now let's have a look at what our buy Nier Automata. Seriously, just buy it. I don't. Oh shit! Wait. Oh, whew, thank God! I accidentally switched my timer. This is gonna be a long one, isn't it? What's next after this one? Well, I still have a few other GameCube games that I want to record. that are going to be for this. Basically, what it's going to be is all the even number ones in the Nier Way Out series. Clever name, I know, right? But every single one of the even number ones that I kind of decided at some later point, like 2 days ago, I decided, you know what, I could just make all those be GameCube games. And then it was so. But yeah, I have, this one is going to be six, should be at least. I have two more for four and two. The games are going to be, something that's been done to death and something which should be dead by now. Two things that are not let me say that again. One thing that never was quality and another thing that has lost it. And then I have, let me see. I still have Wait. I'm missing a game. My eyes is kind of glazed over it. No. I have two Wii games and then two PS4 games. One of the PS4 games I might have a bit of trouble with. Just a bit of trouble. And the other one I'm still going to have trouble with. But not the same kind. Wow. You just ran right into that, didn't you? Push. What's collision, guys? I don't fucking know. I'm getting hungry, by the way. I already had some food. But a small amount of food is not enough. Huh. Well, judging by how New England's doing, they're going to win. Again. God, the Falcons are just getting their ass kicked. Quarterback an option. What are they doing? Oh God! Did every single character model just phase out of existence for a second before they reset? You know, I'm starting to think some of these games aren't that well put together. Why am I just noticing all this now? Makes no sense to me. Not when I was playing it, but now. Oh God. Do you know I'm a writer in my off time? Well, aspiring writer. Well, I don't write that as much as I used to. I used to write a lot, and then things took an emotional downturn. How long ago was that? I don't remember. But I used to write a lot. Started writing a detective novel. And I'm looking back at it, and maybe it wasn't the best. I was young when I wrote it. No, I was like, what, 17 or something? And it's this really weird thing that I'm looking at it, and I'm constantly thinking, is it good? Is it fine? Do people like this, what I'm writing? Despite the fact that I actually showed this, I showed my work. I actually have the note. I actually went and picked up the notebook, which had all of my writing in it. And they mentioned And this is someone who read like a whole lot of books. They actually used to do a YouTube channel that was solely devoted to reading books, their favorite books, their opinions on books, and all that kind of stuff. And they read it, and they said, you know, this is really good. I'm really enjoying reading this. The writing teacher I had, I wrote kind of a sequel to it. I never finished it, like a lot of things I do. But
Walter will come into this game to punt. Russell back to return.
I never actually finished it, but I knew how I wanted it to end, so I decided, you know what? I might as well just restart it, you know, whatever. Or not restart it, but continue from where I wanted to leave it off at. And I started writing it, and every chance I got, and the writing teacher was like, you know, this is really good. This is really good. I really enjoy reading it. I do enjoy writing, but now that I've been out of school for some time now, and I tried to keep up with writing stuff, but it's a lot different. When you know someone when they read something, and you know, just posting it online and all that kind of stuff, and that people usually just don't care. And I can put my heart and my soul into it, and people just like, okay, yeah, sure, cool. It's discouraging, you know. I want to keep doing it. It's the same thing with all of these YouTube videos that I keep doing. But I try to keep up the effort, keep up the general fun guy appeal. I do my best, but it's hard, you know. It's difficult. And there are times where I just want to do what I'm doing now and lay back and just sigh and look in the... just stare out the window while the world around me starts grayscaling and I start playing Evanescence. It's a weird thing, something you might not know about me. I never actually went through that phase in my life. Well, I kind of did. Kinda. I grew up in a different lifestyle than I live in now. Right? Like, first off, I didn't swear. I didn't even know swears were a thing. I was such an innocent, pure cinnamon roll thing that I didn't even know that the middle finger was an insult. There were so many things that I didn't know. And even we had a computer, and I would go on the I'd go on the internet for maybe a couple of things, but my parents were always incredibly frightened of it. Incredibly. Like, one of the things. I wanted to get into, like, RuneScape and all that kind of stuff. And they were just my parents were apocalyptically frightened, concerned. Oh, they're gonna eat our credit cards. If you play an online game, it's going to destroy your credit cards. And that got me frightened. I don't know if there's they were trying to do fear-based stuff and get me scared about everything, and that could ever exist.
That's a good job of getting downfield by the cover team.
But it certainly worked. But yeah, I didn't really. The only thing I would ever listen to, I could ever listen to, really, was Christian radio. And so, after a certain point in my life, things kind of changed. And I was kind of, in a way, pushed out of the whole. Well, not pushed out, but the lifestyle I lived in was massively different. Like, massively different. Massive. And I found myself in a completely different world than I had known beforehand. I tried to make friends, didn't. Let's not do this now. But, yeah, I didn't really have any experience with any other kind of music. And I will be honest, I didn't think. God, why was I a shit kid? I didn't want to say it was a that it's not a phase. I think at one point I literally said, it's not a phase. This is how it's gonna be now. And I got seriously into rap and all that kind of stuff. And then after a while, where'd I go after that? Good God, I don't remember. Was it pop music? It was. No. Yes? God, I don't remember. God, I can't remember the evolution of music I had. But I went to that kind of stuff, and it went heavy, and it was a edgy place in my life. A very edgy place. It's not a dark place like where I'm at now. Well, I'm actually not in such a bad position that I was beforehand. I mean, hell, you know what? Me sitting here talking, doing any of this, and putting it out online, me speaking with any sort of confidence, this is something that I couldn't have imagined doing beforehand. I mean, I can't imagine going out and doing this in public, because I do have kind of big stage fright and anxiety and all that kind of stuff. But, oh good, it's almost over. This is still going. But yeah, we eventually got into this place where I'm at now, where I've kind of stopped listening to the radio. Because, I mean, I'll listen to Pandora and all that kind of stuff, but there's nothing on the radio that really appeals to my tastes anymore. Nowadays, it's either internet, like songs made by people on the internet, it's either that, disco, 80s music, or JoJo. Or a theme song for Space Jam. This is great. Man. I want to write more. I don't know what to write about, though. Huh.
With a man in motion.
Huh. You know, one of these days I should actually really reread the story I did. The story of John Rifton, because I liked Skyrim. Actually, I really liked the last name Rifton. I just think John Rifton was such a cool name. It still is, too. I'm not going to say it's not, because then it'd be lying. It still sounds like a cool name to me. The name is Rifton. John Rifton. One of these times, I should just redo this. I should not redo it, but I should just rewrite it, or write up what I have here, put it online, see what people think. I actually think I made a thing about that on social media, and I got nothing because no one listens to me or pays attention to me or gives a shit that I do anything. Whatever. God. Atlanta, unless you pull a win out of your ass, you're not winning this. You know what? I could probably just go into my end spiel right now. The game's almost over. Well, I say the game's almost over when it still has about, let me see, there's still 1:13 on the clock, so that means we still have about 5 more hours left. But, God. You know, honestly, I should divvy up fake commercials. Just make them, just put them in here. So you can have the real football experience. Oh my God, you know what? Benatera comes in to kick off. That wouldn't be the worst thing ever. Booming kick downfield. No, it would be. I'm sorry, it would be. From the one. Oh, man. But, yeah. If you like what you, I mean, maybe not saw, but heard. If you like that, then don't forget to like, favorite, and subscribe. I'll be continuing along. I'll be doing more games later on. And, great recognition by the quarterback, knowing where to go with the football against the blitz, and knowing how to doing more games, recording more. I'll be recording a lot more. I still have to record Dark Souls. I spent basically an hour just doing this one video, and I still have 7 Dark Souls videos too. Oh, this is a bad choice. But yeah. What the fuck was that? I'm gonna start to hit your shoe. Oh, I know why they did that. It's so they could buy themselves time. Alright, that makes sense. With the throw, incomplete pass. But yeah. New England has won. There literally is nothing else that Atlanta could do at this point. Unless someone just pulls magic out, there is no way they could win this. But, yeah, 10 Atlanta. Then stop grabbing your arm, you fuck. They don't need to run any type of play here. But yeah, let's just watch this out. It's first and 10. I didn't really watch the Super Bowl or the commercials. I don't really care about it anymore. Oh my God. Oh, I see what New England's done. Yeah, I get it now. They don't have to do anything now. They could literally just hold right here and not do anything. The game knows what it's doing. But, yeah. It's been fun. It's been a good time. And I hope to see. And, nope, yeah, there it goes. New England has won. Patriots. Wow. That's okay, Patriots wins. They win no matter what, it looks like. So, yeah. I really hope you've enjoyed this. And, that's it. Bye.